We are going to prove that the sum of 1 factorial, 2 factorial, up to n factorial cannot be a perfect power for all integer n greater than 3. And we are going to use modulo arithmetic to prove this. Now let's actually frame this proof by a proof by contradiction, where we assume for contradiction that it is possible for the sum of first n factorials to be a perfect power, which we will denote as a to the b. We will show that this cannot be true. The first case that we are going to consider is the case when b is even. That is, the sum of first n factorials is a perfect square, and we will let b to be 2m, where m is a positive integer. We see that for n being equal to 4, the sum of 1 factorial to 4 factorial turns out to be 33, which as you may expect to be a non-perfect power. Then when n is greater than or equal to 5, we note that the sum of first n factorials will be congruent to 3 mod 5. Since all the factorials after 4 factorial will have a multiple of 5, and so all of them are congruent to 0 mod 5. Whereas for the sum of 1 factorial to 4 factorial, it is 33, as we have calculated this earlier, and it is congruent to 3 mod 5. So, the whole sum is indeed congruent to 3 mod 5. However, this means that we have a perfect square which is congruent to 3 mod 5, which is a contradiction, as we can check all the possible residues of squares mod 5 to see that the quadratic residues mod 5 are only 0, 1, and 4, which we can see that 3 is not a quadratic residue. Hence, this means that the sum of first n factorials cannot be an even power. Next, we move on to the case when b is odd. That is, the sum of first n factorials is an odd power. Well, what we will do is that we will first deal with the case when n is greater than or equal to 9 first. And we will deal with the smaller values of n later. We first observe that the sum of 1 factorial to 8 factorial can be calculated to be 46233, which is congruent to 9 mod 27. That is, the sum is a multiple of 9 but not a multiple of 27. Then if we continue to add more factorials up to n factorials, we still have the sum of first n factorials in this case to be congruent to 9 mod 27. Since the factorials greater than 8 factorials are all multiples of 27, which means that they are congruent to 0 mod 27. However, here's the problem. Since 3 obviously divides the sum, this gives 3 divides a, which in turn gives 3 power 6 divides the sum. Now, because b is an odd integer greater than 1, we will have 3 to the 3, which is 27, divides the sum. This means that the sum is also congruent to 0 mod 27, which is a contradiction since we have just shown earlier that it is congruent to 9 mod 27. So when n is greater than or equal to 9, the sum cannot be an odd power. And now for n less than 9, we can manually check that the cases when n being 4, 5, 6, 7 or 8 will not give a perfect power, which I will leave you to verify them on your own if you want to. Hence, when b is odd, we have shown that the sum cannot be an odd power, and this ultimately proves the whole statement of the problem. If you enjoy watching this video, please like and subscribe, and be sure to watch this video where I solve a number theory problem from the USA Math Olympiad program. I will see you in that video.